idea for Yatra came while having a drink in a pub.
Journey at Yatra, roller coaster for sure, fun and exciting.
For me, it's been successful.
Exciting?
It's been a fantastic experience for me. There's no other word.
Challenging?
Very meaningful.
It was great fun.
Exhilarating.
Extremely satisfying.
Challenging.
Fulfilling.
Connecting with teams and people.
If I were to do it again, yes, I would.
And I had the best time of my life.
The Yatra journey has been exciting. You know, when Dhruv told me it's really challenging, it proved to be extremely challenging. And there have been lots of ups and downs. I think, fortunately, more highs than lows.
When we came here, we hired rent apartment. And when I came, I saw only sofa and a fridge. Dekha. No dining table, nothing.
We're working out of a business center. All of us were just writing the codes and working on a laptop in a simple conference room. And in the evening, we would go to Manish's place. He had a big flat. His fridge was just packed with beer. We used to pick up the beer, do the work. And that's how we launched the best company in 2006.
I still remember the booking made on Yatra was my friend from Deloitte. He booked the tickets and that ticket was not visible on any platform, the backend that we have developed. So we were wondering, my friend was calling me, yaar, maine booking kar di hai, kuch deo to sahi, confirmation number to do.
I remember when we first sold our first air ticket and it was not an e-ticket, we decided to send chocolates along with a paper of envelope with e-ticket. And then one day we got a call from one of our customers, hey, thank you. Well, chocolates was amazing, but where is my tickets?
When I joined Yatra, you know, I was bachelor. And Manish was kind of I was unmarried bachelor and Manish was married bachelor, right? So Sabina used to tease us specially that you guys are now a married couple.
You gotta be joking, man.
I think I can almost, you know, write a thesis. I think he's very passionate, you know, about the business. Extremely passionate.
Dhruv, everyone finds him serious, but you know, I've known him outside of office as well. When he's outside, the guy can party like hell.
Once I was at a conference there and Dhruv was also there from Yatra and he was supposed to be speaking at the conference the next day. And that evening, two of us went out and you know, we got a few drinks and a few drinks became more than a few drinks. And the next morning when I woke up groggily and you know, headed off for the conference, I got a message from Dhruv saying that he has some urgent work back in India and he's heading back. And I think all that happened was that he was too hungover to speak actually out there.
Dhruv was really good at being able to balance his time between family and work.
Dhruv is very sharp, analytical.
You know, when he gets angry, he's like, I give a rat sass. That's his one of his pet dialogues.
My grandfather used to say that if you find something you enjoy, you'll never go to work. And I think that is really true for Dhruv.
Dhruv, I guess, obviously compliments both of these guys just purely from one, I guess, a maturity level. And then two, also, I guess to be able to bring all of this together in a very coherent way.
He can be an amazing dancer. You know, he's a good cricketer and we've seen, you know, his cricketing skills. We've seen his dancing in a lot of offsides.
Manish clearly is a hard tech, is a hardcore technology person, but he also marries that very well with the sound understanding of the business.
I have learned perseverance from Manish because I'm a bit short-tempered, but Manish is not, so.
Manish wanted to move to India, but he's done something really good. Matlab, jo unka jo dream thi, it come true.
He's extremely loyal. He's very talented. And he's extremely loyal, and that's something that I've always admired.
Well, to be very honest, Manish is a sweetheart, right? He's a darling of everyone.
Initially, when Manish came here, so I took him out for dinner. And after the dinner, I was in my element to drive a little fast that time. So by the time I had whizzed past most of the Delhi roads in traffic, Manish was all packed up. I can't be in Delhi anymore if Adesh is going to drive like this. Manish, as we always called him.
Manish's memories are, or Manish's stories are best left to his team, from his Ahata moments to his, you know, Machan moments.
Manish is a great believer in people. He loves people, he believes in them.
Post our kind of working hours, I worked with Manish very closely actually. So we were like boyfriend and girlfriend after that.
If you give her a slot of 15 minutes to speak, or there's a 15-minute meeting, Sabina would take 20 out of those 15 minutes to talk.
She brings that fun element that, you know, hey guys, let's do this, let's do that. So I think she's great at that.
Sabina ma'am, she's talkative and very bubbly person.
Sabina, I guess, is a hardcore salesperson. And clearly, you know, literally by her every action, you can very well see that across the way she talks. The way she's able to pull bullshit through.
Sabina has amazing sense of humor. Her laughter is just amazing.
She was very confident she'll be able to deliver. She's bold in taking her decisions. It is due to her diligence. It's her honesty with the work. I know Dhruv and Manish are going to say, woo.
The first time I met Sabina was at Delhi Airport when we were going for a fam trip. She was from Yatra. I didn't know her. And I asked her if she works for Bhavna. And Bhavna was the person I was interacting with in Yatra. And Sabina looked at me and said, no, I don't work for Bhavna. So I didn't understand what she was meaning. And much later when I joined Yatra and I found out that she was a co-founder, I thought, to jaan se maar degi mere ko.
There's a famous quote that someone made to Sabina, which was,
Sabina ji, let's do it. From that moment onwards, you know, that Sabina ji, let's do it, has stuck with Sabina forever.
I think Sabina ji, you've kept on doing it for all these years, and we've greatly enjoyed your company as part of this.
Clearly, there is no finger pointing at me on this one.
And Sabina for sure.
No, not really. There's a war between us. It's never give up. Today I've got a point. Believe me, I'm not going to say it here, but he's cooked.
Both of us are.
There's a bond which has been created which can actually never be broken. So we know that each one is there for each other, and we know how the other one thinks, or how is the other one going to react. So whereas Dhruv, I say, is the serious one, and Manish is the one who plays all the pranks and day-to-day pranks with me, which is simply amazing. And that's what carries the light element to it.
There was a time in 2011, we'd raised about 200 odd crores at that point of time, and we obviously wanted to roll that out to the entire management team. So I think Dhruv did call out a meeting for the entire management team to announce this.
And we all kind of gathered together in a conference room, and Dhruv said, I want to share something very important with you. And all of a sudden Dhruv starts, listen guys, with a very heavy heart, I want to share something with you. And I'm like, what the hell is happening? He says, listen guys, the board has decided, and I've decided, that I'll be moving on. And they would be hiring a new CEO for Yatra. And we were speechless, all of us. And like,
and he actually said it with a lot of emotions, and it literally came from his heart. It almost seemed like as he was choking upon his emotions when he said this. It was like pin drop silence in the room, and everybody was wondering, what the hell, how did this come about? Nobody knew about this.
And after maybe a pause of a few seconds, like, listen guys, I'm just joking with you, nothing of that sort happening.
I'm just joking, don't really have any intention to move on, I've been born to run this business.
Being the youngest of the lot, I unfortunately have to play the role of the mediator.
I'm the second one, he's the eldest.
I tried with these two senior citizens, but that's just something that comes with maturity.
Love that with maturity.
I think it's one of the amazing founding teams. It has everything going for it.
I think they were really enjoying what they were doing, and I think that's what's really kept them together.
They're very friendly, no doubt about it. They're very humble, yet fiercely competitive.
Once they learn to trust, I think there's no limit to the empowerment that each one of them gives you.
It's their empowerment of the teams and trusting the teams is what I believe makes them the real leaders.
It's a great team, it's a great organization. I think there's a great opportunity ahead.
They're a believer in the concept, they're very focused, they have the vision, to do what it takes. I've given some of my best years, and in fact, that's true with every founding team member. You know, we've all given some of our best years to Yatra.
We were the initial bunch of people who have not thought of, you know, that we are joining a startup where anything can happen. We just joined Yatra.
I think it was a dream for us. What kept us going while, you know, this entire challenges, there are so many challenges which happen on a day-to-day basis, on a weekly basis and month. But what made us go through was that dream.
You know, chance of getting something right or building something was always kept us motivating. We knew that we would be successful. We knew that we had the ability. We had a good team set up and we knew we could do it.
The main thing that kept me motivated through all of this was the fact that I had a team that A, believed in me, and then a team that I believed in. Completing 10 years is a real milestone. I don't think when we set up, we ever envisage that we will get to this stage, right? You read all these statistics about the high percentage of failures of startups and how, you know, most startups disappear within, you know, 12 months of setting up. And here we are talking about 120 months.
I don't think it's been 10 years. I somehow feel it's just yesterday since we started this company. It's so fresh, and I think that's what makes the difference, because you're seeing, you're not letting those, it's been 10 years, my God, no. It's just been yesterday since we started. So the passion of a startup, the passion for making it even further more successful is still there with us.
To be honest, we still feel like the first day. We're still in a startup phase. We are still thinking of new ideas, still trying to improve the site, improve the user experience, trying to get as much of a travel products online as possible.
It's been an amazing journey, which has changed me personally. So when I joined, when I come back 10 years back and to what I am now, there's been a huge growth internally for me also.
I think it's been an emotional roller coaster as far as Yatra is concerned.
I like to congratulate to Manish and everyone involved making what Yatra is today. Of course, their hard work, passion for the company is shown, and I really sincerely from my heart that I hope they celebrate many, many more years.
Dhanyavad and Shubh Yatra.